Hello again, I'm back after my various tasks and visitors, etc. So, here we go, part two of this disastrous start. I've had about two or three disasters, and I haven't even picked up my load yet. Right, we are somewhere en route to Amsterdam. And it wasn't my fault. I was heading in the wrong direction because I picked the job up at a railway station. And, not railway station, the refilling station. Oh my god. Yeah, and, at a fuel station. And, I didn't know where it was, and it was on like a motorway, the fuel station was. I didn't know where the pickup job was. And, it transpires that because it's a motorway, it's one way, and therefore, sod's law, I'm heading in the wrong bloody direction. I did try to turn round unsuccessfully, through a very small gap in the armature to my left, and it wouldn't let me. So I'm kind of looking for an exit to get back onto the right way, really. By which time I've probably run out of time. Well, let's see anyway. I wonder if there's any places here I could turn around. I wouldn't do this in real life, don't worry. It doesn't look very sociable, let's say that. It looks like a bridge of some description, and I don't know there's going to be any turnaround points here. If I do see one, I'm travelling at 61 miles an hour, I'll probably slam the anchors on and have someone up my arse. Right. Very unhelpful, that'll do. Right. Right her off. Shouldn't do that. But I've done it, so they're tough. Righty ho. It's not choosing the gears properly. That's better. It doesn't like it if I change gear too quickly. It gets confused. It might read, it might display the correct gear, but it's not the correct gear. It revs the bollocks off it. Right, come on, let's get going. I've got 47 bloody miles to go. I don't have to do this, though, do I? Because I haven't contracted to do it. Let's see where else there is. Does this tell you where it is located? In relation to you, where you are. But it was quite a good earner, wasn't it? No, I'm still going to do it. That one, yeah. No, I'm going to go and do it. I'm going to do it because I'm greedy. I'm going to do it. Right, and I'm going to do it quick, and I'm going to do it good. Right. 80 miles an hour in a R620 Scania. I've got to be careful. What can these go? What speed can these go to safely? Mind you, I've got to watch the speeding for the penalties, haven't I? As well. And the handling, so I don't trash it. Right, I think we're getting off here then. We're going to keep this lane and go round. Strange ends to motorways they have. It's kind of a loop-de-loop. Frequently, I've gone onto the right-hand lane there, accidentally, and gone wrong. But not often now. Still do it sometimes, but when I'm not concentrating. Which isn't often. Okay. AI car suddenly slam his ankles on. Oh, he hasn't. Right, we'll catch up with you. We'll be there in 5 minutes. 26 miles to go. Turn those headlights off. Right. Let's get this show on the road. It's 4:26 a.m. Wow. I've got the yawns, I'm afraid. Isn't a very well lit motorway. Wow, I better watch out for signs here because it looks like it's getting a bit populated, shall we say, urbanised. Just in case. I don't like it when they all slow down and I'm the idiot who ploughs past them at 70 miles an hour in a 50 limit. Look what I can do sort of thing. Not very clever when they lump a £440 fine on you. What the heck? Okay, we're bearing right here to Amsterdam itself. Okie dokie. Mile to go. Is it coming up here somewhere on the... Where is it? I can't see it. On the left, I think. Okay, see what my voice is like over the row of this engine. Oh yeah, ferocious, man. Okay. The weeks and weeks I've been driving, the amount of miles I've done, I still take off in first gear in a truck. You don't have to. Take off in second or third, depending on your load and your truck. Okay. Come along. Done it again. I think we're up here on the left then, are we? I don't play every day on this, I have to say. That probably shows by the quality of my driving. And my computer, as my loyal subscribers, all four of you will know, I had immense problems with this computer. I've got it in August and it's been off the road longer than it's been on the road, as it were, because of problems, and we got the problem sorted. I think I've had it back for 3 weeks tomorrow, Sunday, about 3 weeks, and it's been behaving as it should. As it should have done from day one. Right, what are we doing? Anything else on there? I wonder if that's a... Oh, cool. No. I'm going to go for that one, I think. Yep, I like the money. 3.856. No, that's a good rate. And that's what I'm going to do. So my cargo will be there. My trailer. To give it its proper name according to the game there. Your trailer is there and ready to load. Hitch up to... I think it's fireworks. I think it said. And it is fireworks. I'm going to Poznan. Right, I better stop waffling and just get on with it. Okay. Poznan. I'm going left out the door. Here we go. Lovely jubbly. Hit a red light as soon as I'm on my way. quite, what's the word, in your face, those lights, aren't they, those orange flashing lights. Change it to seconds, here we get on. Gonna have to try and get used to doing that, because it saves sort of wear and tear, and it just saves crunching through the gears. If I start in second. What a great idea. Oh, I'm almost in that lane as well, aren't I? Almost, not quite. What is that thing? Is it like a winch in the back there? Like a crane? Yeah, I think it is. All those fireworks. Wow. Sparklers and bangers and rockets and things. Okie dokie. We've got quite a way to go. Wow, I think I've caught every red light so far. Got quite some power, this old girl. That can sort of get you into trouble if you're not careful through speeding, etc. Yeah, let's just catch another set of reds. This could add 20 minutes to a journey. This is my fourth set, is it? AM on a Wednesday morning. Come along. At least I want to make some inroads into this. Okay, we're going left and there's no lights, but you have got to give way. That's safe enough for me. That's good. I think we're getting better now. What I'm going to do is, as we're abroad, I'm going to swap to K per hour. I think it's that. I should know by now, but I am a bit rusty. Use miles? No. Okay. Here we go. Oh, income, here we go, 579, driver mark. Yep, okay, I've got 9 drivers, I think, so where are the rest of you, please? Aha, none, right, lovely. Mark's the only one working, is he? Alrighty. See how we're doing for sleep, we should be fairly topped up. 4 hours, okay. Yeah, okay. I normally like to get down to about 2 hours, hour and a half, 2 hours, and that's fine. So, what does Wednesday bring us? Speed. I'm not sure what the speed limit is here. I just generally watch the other trucks, and if I see the or the other vehicles as a whole, and if I see the brake lights slam on, I think, best slow down. We're doing about 60 miles an hour, 62 I think, is 100. We're straight on here at the next junction. Lovely. Never had one of those cars. I don't know if that's only available at a certain level. I don't think I've ever seen that as an option for your cargo, for your trailer, a la Eddie Stobart, or I can't think of any other names of UK companies anyway that transport vehicles. I think it might be a level when you achieve a certain level. Because I imagine a car is going to be anything between, what, 7 and 100 grand? And you got, what, 6, 8, 10 of them? That's a lot. That is a lot. Anyway, I'll make do with fireworks, thank you very much, and I'll get 33 grand, hopefully, provided I get to this destination safe and on time or early. We've got 1807 is our ETA. Mind you, I'm biting into that now as I'm skating along here, knocking minutes off the ETA. Last time I did that, as I said in part one of this, last time I did that, I was waffling along and it had started to rain, and I'd said, oh, you know, I've gained an hour on this trip and I've made up loads of time, blah blah blah, and I said, provided nothing goes wrong, I'll be fine. And then it started to rain, and I looked down at my keyboard and went to press P for the windscreen wipers, and at that stupidly critical time I'd sailed past the exit for the motorway on which I was driving, and I cursed, and it was like ages to the next exit, so I did a very naughty and highly illegal but got away with it manoeuvre, and turned around, did a U-turn on the motorway. Waited for a gap on the Armco and just did a with a big trailer on the back, and I got away with it. Oh, I don't know, I'm a nightmare sometimes, honestly, nightmare. But of course, as you know, it's all tongue-in-cheek. I'm only doing this as a muckabout. But anyway, let's get on. It's now 6:10 on Wednesday morning. I'm sailing down here. Oh, here we go again, you see, as I'm talking about rain. Oh, spooky. I'm going to do the lottery in a minute. I'm saying some key things just as they happen. So I'll just get some numbers in my head. If I win several million, this is on record on YouTube, if I win several million, I will consider donating some to Excalibur Publishing, whoever makes this program. They probably wouldn't be, well, of course they would be interested, that's a stupid thing to say. Become a sponsor of them or something. Because I think it's a cracking, it's a bally good game, it really is, simulator. Bloody good. Right, enough of that, let's have a look. 3 hours, that's a wee bit early. It's a wee bit early to stop. Let's do this. Tell you what, let's do that. That's what I meant to do. I said I'm rusty, didn't I? We have got not many stations, but I reckon I should be able to get to there soon. Worst case scenario, if I'm struggling around Osnabrück, I will see about popping in there, maybe unhitching my trailer and popping in a little place there. Does it go any more than that? No, it doesn't. Or maybe there, if that's one behind that garage. And I could also at the same time unlock that, which is, I don't know, some either an employment agency or some truck dealer, I reckon. But anyway, let's give it a go. Back to there. So I'm not going to stop here. Too late now, even if I did want to. Or is it there? That's where it is, isn't it? I'm not going to, though. Not going to. Okay, so I've got about an hour and a half before things start getting a bit dodgy on the old sleep, and I'm very confident of getting to that second garage before I have any problems. So I've been listening to a fair few YouTube videos over Christmas, and as I've said many times before, I am my harshest critic. Mostly, I think, mostly people access YouTube for information or entertainment. That's it, you know. And I certainly access YouTube for information, products before I buy them, cameras, printers, whatever. Excuse me just a moment. Saskia has leveled up. Lovely. Well, level, but this brings some money in, please. Anyway, back to YouTube. And I've noticed a wide differentiation of quality of not so much the videos but the audio on the video, and some are good and some are awful. Some are loud, some are not loud. And I just want to be able to present my videos as pretty professional, you know. People are... How can I say this? They don't know how much they know. They don't realise what they know, because the quality of the TV that they watch, even the soaps and all this stuff, is so highly produced. It really is very good. I'm not saying the soap itself is good. I'm saying the quality of the production, the film work, the camera work, the directing, the acting, the producing, da 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 da. And people, I think, you know, are more experts than they know they are, than they think they are. And basically, they get used to that level of quality. And if a poor video that is not up to that is seen or heard or watched on YouTube, that shows up a mile. It really does. And that's why I aim, A, because I want to, and B, because I know I can produce half decent videos. They're not broadcast standard, but I just want to do as good a job as my equipment and experience will allow. I pay lots of money for my equipment, which are cameras, microphones, computers, lenses, audio recorders, etc., etc. And I don't want to be all the gear and no idea, as we say over here in the UK, whereby just because you've got good gear, it means that you're going to be brilliant. There's a lot of people out there who've got the gear and don't have an idea how to use it. Well, I don't want to be like that. I want to enjoy my equipment, and I want to be able to use it to the best of my judgment and ability and experience. Truck driving is probably not one of those skills I have, but I do enjoy trying to put together a half decent and audible and watchable video production on YouTube, and hopefully it will bring, you know, everything I do on this particular channel is just tongue-in-cheek. It's not very serious, you know, and I wouldn't want to be taken seriously, but you know, I do it for fun and to relax sometimes, you know, if I've had a hard day. I'm waffling on now, but all I'm saying is there's a lot of different quality on YouTube, and I just want to kind of practice, if you like, apply the skills I've learned over the years with the lovely equipment I've got to this environment. And it's one of the very, very few environments that I have that I can totally control, provided the equipment's working okay and computers aren't blue screening, which is what this one did a few times. Provided I can control the equipment, then I am totally in control. When I record, I don't do that many weddings now because everyone's at it, but if I record a show, a dance show or a school show, I don't have complete control because parents and people will talk while the production's on if they're sitting near a microphone. Kids will cough, sneeze, talk, whatever. And this is all extra to the actual thing that I'm there to record, which is the production, the show, the spoken word. I have no control over the lighting, if there is any lighting. I have no control over babies crying, you know. I don't, but here I do. I can turn off my computers. I don't work in a studio as such. It's not soundproofed or anything like that, but I do have control over what mics I use, what I say, what I record, and the background noise as well. I can deaden it, I can decrease it, I can even turn it off, I can extinguish it. And that's all I want to do, you know, just make half decent videos for YouTube, and that's why I'm doing this. So I've seen a lot of these videos, ETS2 videos, that are, in my opinion, pretty boring because no one talks over it. They just drive, and yeah, exactly. It's very boring. Thank you, my profile. And I think you need a voice over, whether it's a good voice or a bad voice, but I still think you need a legible voiceover who can, here we go, who can glue it all together, put it all together, and I just think it helps, it really does. That'll do. just in time. Whoa. So, you know, it's important. And the amount of videos I've seen that you can't hear when I'm doing this, mostly the voice of the ones I've seen, you can't hear them. Now, that's not to say I want to talk like that all the time or have that operation, that view, because I do things like that. Anything that's not this view is dangerous for me because I can't control the truck, and I don't know anyone who can. But you can't hear them when they switch to the outside view because they haven't got the audio levels right. I think I have got them pretty much spot on. And also the quality of the microphones, etc. I think that's very important as well. But, you know, it's not, you don't have to have a top-grade mic. The mic I'm using at the moment is a Rode NTG3. Now, they retail in the UK for about £500 or £600. I got mine off of eBay, and I've got, you know, others like it, you know, and I just go for quality because it gives me... I just love quality, and I can tell the difference, and it's very, very nice indeed. Admittedly, all I'm doing at the moment is putting little YouTube videos together, but if I were to do a voiceover for a production I've done for a client, or sometimes people want to come in and do their own voiceovers or make a CD, then I would use this microphone because it is very good quality. You know, the characteristics of it are very good indeed, whereas other people use maybe a cheap headphone mic or a camera mic, you know, and they're not very good. But as long as you can hear it, I'm definitely waffling now. That's another thing I feel compelled to do when you're driving, is to be saying something, because if I went like this, like you might do in a car or a truck, and you just on your own thoughts, but you're doing this, a lot of you are probably thinking, oh great, he's finally stopped talking. But you do have to say something, you know, a gap of longer than 2 or 3 seconds is not good, in my view. So you do need to keep talking. Anyway, right, I better find somewhere to stop. So what I'm going to do, in the middle of a motorway, I'm going to see where we are. And luckily, I might get away with it, I might not, but I'm going to stop at that garage there so that my ever so tired profile man can have a sleep. So that's what I'm going to do. And hopefully that's going to be in not too far, because I saw his eyes starting to get a bit dodgy, and that's when they start dishing out the £120 fines, alleging you're too tired, etc., etc., and you can't just pull over. So one has to be careful. I think I might just get away with it. We've got half a kilometre to go, 500 metres. Let's give it a go. I think I'm okay for fuel, definitely okay for fuel. We've got 500k to go, and I've got double that in fuel, so that's what I'm going to get. I don't do this often. I normally go straight in and get some fuel and whatever, but this time, because I have got fuel and because I'm struggling for time, I'm just going to pull it over here, park it haphazardly, and when I hear that lovely sound there, I'm going to put the handbrake on, kill the engine and get some sleep, and I'm going to wake up in 9 hours time, and I bet you it's not raining. It will be 1800, it will be 6:22 in the evening. Remember this weather? Watch what happens next. It'll rack up 9 hours. Hey, hey, always happens. It's not a bad thing. Right, let's get going. Check that no one's stolen me fireworks. How would I know? I don't know. Anyway. Let's just do this and get on with it. So, ranting on there and waffling, A, because I feel I need to, as I said, for the reasons I've just outlined on these videos, but B, well, I just think I want to. But there are some people with good voices, not me. Watch what happens here, which is normally do. Yeah, that was lucky. There are some people with good voices, not me, and there are some people with not so good voices, and there are some people with awful voices. I don't think mine's awful. It's not quite monotone. It's not like, and I'm talking, I'm driving along here and I'm going to Poznan with some fireworks. It's not like that. But it's not overly interesting. It's like a radio presenter voice. And, you know, I haven't got one of those, I'm sure. Some people have. And also, what they say is vaguely pertinent to what they're doing at the time, whereas I tend to just waffle on, you know, generally. But, you know, that's just a difference in the contributors on YouTube, I suppose. But as I say, I just do this purely tongue-in-cheek. It's a bit of a laugh, bit of a joke. It's not serious. It's not meant to be serious. And I'm sure it's not taken seriously, because it ain't serious. It's as simple as that. On lots of comments on other YouTube videos I've seen, there are some really nasty people out there, and they're so shallow that they don't, well, I don't think they really know what they're doing. They take everything so seriously and call people names and whatever. Oh, you asshole. By adopting a slight American accent, I wasn't suggesting it was Americans just then, by the way. But, you know, they just sort of go straight for the jugular. And, you know, geez, get a life, man. There's very little tolerance on some of them, but I try and cover everything I do. Like, I'm not an expert, I'm not a gamer, I'm not a brilliant truck driver, blah blah blah. I just do it for the fun and for the reasons I've just spent 15 minutes waffling on about. I like to use the equipment I've got in a non-professional manner, i.e. I'm not being paid to make these videos, whereas, you know, using the camera, which I'm not using the camera, but using the cameras and microphones I have, I'm normally being paid, and I have to do a good job. These ones, I just merrily waffle on, and there we go. Right, there is... Oh, he's going faster than me, so it can't be that bad a speed limit. Mind you, he's slowing down there. Two critiques I would level at myself. Sometimes I speak too fast, and I don't mean to do so, but sometimes I speak too fast, and when I'm listening to some of my videos, I actually don't understand what I've just said because I'm speaking too fast. This speed, I think, is quite okay. And another thing I do is I don't mean to waffle, but I'm waffling because something is coming out of my mouth, and I think you would disagree probably, but I think that this waffle is better than... if you get my point. Some of you may disagree. And there's a couple of people out there who do pretty good videos, and what they say, they have got a natural ability to talk about, like, even that there, the digger thing. I've just called it a digger thing. They would know the correct name for it and have something vaguely interesting and pertinent to say about that. Well, I haven't. I mean, I don't even know what those flowers are called there. You know, oh, things like that. What I am good at is waffling and drifting when I'm not looking straight and ignoring or not seeing road speed signs. So quite often I'm whacked with a fine. But yeah, overall, you know, I'm quite happy with what I've done. I've got 50 odd videos now on several different channels, and yeah, I haven't got many subscribers. I wouldn't expect to have. And I think also that once you have got several hundred or thousand, that almost commits you to make more, because I think it's fear of failure, whatever failure may be on YouTube. You've got like a little, and I'm doing the inverted commas sign with my fingers here, you've got like a following who appear to be interested in what you're doing, and that... I lead a very, very, very business life, socially and work-wise, and that would put an additional strain, if you like, additional pressure on me to find the time to make these videos for any followers, subscribers that I might have, because I don't have the time all the time. Many days I'm working, if I'm not out filming or photographing or doing audio recording, I'm in my office doing conversion work for videotapes and camcorder tapes and LPs and cassettes, etc., etc. I'm doing that for just before Christmas. I was working 15 hours a day, 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. I love it, but I also did it because I had to, because most people wanted their tapes or whatever returned to them and converted in time for Christmas. It ain't a problem. It is a problem if I have to also find the time to do YouTube videos, etc., for my subscribers, and I'm ignoring my work. That's when it becomes a problem. So I think I have to put everything into a priority listing, and that's why I just do these for fun. I don't take them seriously, and they're not meant to be taken seriously. Anyway, as I said, keep saying, you know, I'm waffling, and that's enough of that. But just to put everyone in the picture. And so, where are we going? Poznan or something, isn't it? Poznan? Stokes? Oh, that's the company, isn't it? Stokes. And we've got quite a way to go. And we have got 326. Ah, this is what I love. Income. Will. Good old Will. Lovely, lovely. That little orange number there, which 168975. I love when I'm driving along here. I love seeing that go up, but it's been lovely. Obviously, starting to talk fast there. Obviously, the more, you know, the higher up the level you are, I assume the jobs get better, more rewarding. The drivers that you employ go up in their own way as well, their own levels. And they bring in more than just a few hundred pound. They bring in, I think the best I've had was Melanie, I think, who brought me in $13,000 on a job a few projects ago. It was a few weeks back. And I just doing some outside views on a country road like this and whatever, and the AI, you call it, the artificial intelligence, there was a truck full of logs in front of me, and he just decided to stop. He wasn't stopping because he had to turn into a side road or whatever. He just stopped, and I just got back from this view to that view there, and then he'd stopped, and I just ploughed into the back of him. I had to nurse my truck along to a garage some way away, and it kept cutting out, and the four-way flashers come on, and it cost me a whopping £13,000 to repair. And then seconds later, as if by magic, this Melanie had earned me £13,000 on a job. So I broke even, which was lucky. I'd rather have had £13,000 in the bank straight away, net profit, but there we go. Yeah, that was it. So that's it. And another thing I found, being critical of myself, I also say "there we go" a lot. There we go. Oh well, there we go. Things like that. A lot of people do that on the YouTube videos I've seen. They go, "Yeah, yeah," like that. I think it's just, I just did it then. I think it's just natural, really, and maybe I analyse too much, but you know, whatever. So it's yeah. There you go, there we go, whatever. They're the main critique I have. Right, let's have a look at what we are doing here. It's now 4 minutes to nine, and we are going to stick on the main drag and go in one of their loop-de-loops. On to another road. He's slowing down, A, because he's sensible. Is there, there won't be a speed camera here, will there? No, but I am carrying a few ton, so I better be careful, I suppose, otherwise we'll have fireworks everywhere. It'll be fireworks. What the hell is that? Like a electrical substation. Wow. Wonder if that's there in real life. Well. Okay. Well, we've got a nice few bob in the bank. Oh, I'd like to get, when I have, I don't like bank loans at this level, and what I'd like to consider is being patient, doing a few more of these big ones where, you know, we're talking 20, 30k income, provided I'm not reckless and get fined heavily and crash and stuff like that, I should be bringing home most of that income. And then I want to put that into a couple more trucks. I'm not particularly into modding my own truck with bloody stars and stripes and all this crazy paintwork and stuff. If it can make the truck go better, not look better, go better, and, you know, make it better for the truck itself and the performance, then I'm all for it, but I don't do all this multi crazy colour stuff. So, you know, that's what I'm looking to do, and maybe get a few more trucks. And as you work your way up, obviously you'll get a few more trucks, a few more drivers, and hopefully I'll maybe even have at some point a seven-figure or six-figure sum, i.e. millions or hundreds of thousands. I've got hundreds of thousands now, 169, but, you know, maybe, can you go that far? Million in the bank? I don't know. We'll find out in a few months' time, a few weeks' time maybe, a few months. But it's a great feeling. You're doing your own thing here, trucking along somewhere in Europe, Eastern Europe, and you see your drivers bringing money in trucks that you've bought with hard-earned cash, and it's a good feeling, you know. And it's a reflection of life. It can be a reflection of life. If you work hard and reinvest money, try not to borrow too much. You know, there are rewards to be had if you keep your head cool. Here we go. A left curve. Lovely. How far have we got? We've only got 200k to go. That's not that much. I reckon I'll have this done in about 15 to 20 minutes, I reckon. I think we're getting off at this one. Just going to have a slug of water here. Okay. We're getting off here. Going to take us down on to, what road are we on? Lovely. It's a nice dual carriageway. It's 7 minutes past 10 on Wednesday evening. I have got not long to go before the deadline, or the ETA I should say. I think we should be okay, provided I don't do anything silly. And then I'm going to give it a rest after this. Oh, that was close. I'm going to give it a rest after this, and then I think on my next job I'm going to consider getting some fuel. We should be well okay on sleep. Yeah. That's lovely. Okie dokie. That'd be nice to see. That will just take me over then into 200k, I think, with 33 grand coming in. If I don't do anything silly. Ho ho, famous last words. I've got to stop saying that. I really have. Right. See that gap there? As in, a gap of non-talking. Pretty boring, I think. Lovely looking bridge here. Know where the hell we are. Let's have a look, John. Where are we? Oh, near to Berlin. Okay. So we've just got to go down there to Poznan, and we're there. Lovely. We have got 128 to go. Now, what on earth are these things? There's a few of these I've been through. Are they like tolls? That'd be a country, a borderline, wouldn't it? Don't do that, silly boy. These are tolls up here, then. What was that back there, then? Oh, well. Chance to pour out some water. Drift over to this lane. There are sometimes blind spots if you do what I just did in your mirror. And no matter what you think, what the mirror suggests that there is behind you, i.e. nothing, sometimes I've done it and there's been something in the way, in a blind spot, and it's bloody horrible because I think you get fined about £400 or something. Okay, high beam time. Let's get this show on the road. Right. That's bright. Wonder why they don't have motorway lights, street lights here. Presumably for economic reasons. Righty-ho. We're in 12, lovely. Can't go any higher than that. I would say, the aside from the waffle, the weakest point of my game is parking. Other people I've watched, they don't do anything like me. Mirrors used and everything, and they seem to do it in seconds. I can take minutes. There we go. Yeah. It's rare that I've done it fairly promptly, and some have been very kind. Some of the results that I've got, and like the truck is almost 90 degrees, but so long as the trailer's in the vaguely in the hatchings, in the markings, it goes green and you're done, and that's good enough for me. I used to have a Land Rover Discovery with a 24-foot twin axle caravan, which was home from home. It was bloody lovely, and I managed to park that and manoeuvre that okay, and I'm not looking for excuses, but I think that I don't know what you'd call it, the physics on this game, they don't seem to do what you'd expect to in real life, where the turning and whatever, you turn the opposite direction, I know that, but it's the degrees, it's the amount of turn that you apply, and you'd expect something to happen, and I don't know, it just doesn't, or it over does it, it's just not what I would be used to. I don't know if that's a fault or what, but you know, if I'm a crap parker, I'll be the first to say, but I don't think I'm that bad. I think I better slow down here. But yeah, I don't, it doesn't seem to do what you expect it to do sometimes. Why are you slowing down stupidly so that I go in the back? Gonna stick behind him because I think there's someone on my right hand side who's in my blind spot. This is the one where we have to pay. So when we get there, I'm going to attempt a successful parking, and I'm hopefully going to get about 33 grand, which should take me up to about just over 200 grand, about 202 grand, something like that. Very nice indeed. And I might even level up. I'm on 23 at the moment. We have got but 20k to go, and I reckon I'm going to have to be getting off soon. Not here though. Let's move over. In the early days of playing this, it was so easy because I just misread the GPS and I would go off, say, the wrong exit. I still do it very, very. Oh, here we go. Oh dear. Yeah, like that. And if I'm not concentrating, and it, you know, it costs you time to retrace your steps. Can't see a damn thing there. Looks clear. Bang. Right. $4.40. Oh, we're practically there now. Lovely. I don't know. Stop. I don't know if I've been here before. And I've often said, although I don't really know why you'd need it, but I've often said it would be nice to have a total sort of history on this game. I don't know. I'd just be nice, really. But I don't think they do they? So you can see, like, a driver's... Oh, shit, because I'm trying to drink. That was very amateur. You can see on the garage manager screen all the jobs, like the driver's logs, where they've been, everything they've ever done in this game. But I don't suppose that's... I suppose it is sort of... It takes up too much memory or something. Oh, it's a shame I just did that. What I just did. Careless driving. I was trying to negotiate a glass of water around my microphone. I don't do that in real life, I hasten to add, but on this game, the slightest distraction, if I'm looking at the keyboard, or if I'm doing something else or whatever, I do sort of sometimes wander. And obviously you can't really do that because, well, look what just happened. I'll pay for that. Anyway, let's go here. Right, now, remember those parking skills I was talking about? Well. Stokes. Ooh. Right, that's going to sort me out. Okay, I think that's going to... Tell you what I'm going to do. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do this more. I'm going to try and play it a bit cool. Go with this. Oh, I see what's happening, because I don't remember that amount of restrictions, you know, things being in the way basically before. So presumably the higher up you are, the higher level you are, the more difficult they make things. Well, let's play them at their own game. I don't really know what I mean by that. Right. What I'm going to do is do this. Obstacles was the word I was looking for. The amount of obstacles in the way. Right. Now, most people do that. Okay, we'll try that. But I can't... Yeah, alright, this side, but I've got no perspective of what's on the other side. And now you lose it. I'll go back to the way I know. Just check we're okay. Yeah, we got plenty of room. If I straighten up now, it might even let me off. Other people will have had this done 10 times over by now. I've just got to watch that trailer. Yeah, that's hit it. Some of you may want to make a cup of tea or get a beer now, and I'll just give you a shout when it's done in about 2.5 hours. When I watch these videos back, when I'm watching the reversing, it seems a lot clearer what I should be doing, and I'm kind of shouting at the screen of my own that I can't change, of my own video. And I think, you know, but I just don't see that at the time of doing it. We're going to get a green any second now. Probably because I'm thinking too much. There we go. Oh, it's still an excellent. Lovely. Thank you. Have I gone to 24? Yes, I have. Thank you very much. Right, so I've got a few bob in the bank now. That's what I'm going to do. Just have a quick look at my garage. I didn't try eco driving. I'm going to do long distance. Yeah, I'm going to do that. And I'm going to turn off. Turn my lights off. Or extinguish them. Turn those off. Flash my lights. Come down to that level. It's very clever, that. Sound that. It's Tatty Bye from Video Guy. Thanks for watching.